Palm Breeze Cafe. We're with our website of the week. How are you, Kim?
What Kim.
In the world? You're not Kim. Where's Lee?
I'm Lee.
You are Lee.
I'm Lee.
Oh, you know what? Y'all have me this week, but that's okay. When Lee gets back, the other Lee gets back, we're going to have this together.
Okay. So what are we talking about today?
We have Addict-O-Matic.com.
Hmm.
And this is a very, very good website because if you're addicted to the news, if you want information at your fingertips, all types of sources, Addict-O-Matic brings it all together in one place for you.
Well, that's cool. So it's sort of like a meta search engine. It goes out and gets all kinds of things.
That's exactly what it is. And it puts it in widgets that you can customize for your own personal taste.
I don't know who came up with the word addict-o-matic, but
interesting indeed. Addicted to current events. That's what it is.
Very good. And they give you a lot of resources here. In fact, there's browsing the news, all kinds of things right on the screen immediately.
That's exactly right. There's all types of things you can do. For example, there are different hot topics that are in the news already. So if you just wanted to do an Addict-O-Matic search on any one of the top 10, you can just click and it'll create that page for you.
Very nice.
But we wanted to do a search on what?
Let's search for the new Google cell phone that's coming out.
Sounds good.
That's an interesting. Yeah, you notice we already tried that once.
And then we press create.
Okay.
And now, then I'm just going to cancel that. Yeah. That's from mine.
Now, inside the district, we get a lot of things. Can we control the resources we use?
We definitely can control the resources.
Well,
so if you go up to this tab where it says available sources and click on the arrow, there's a drop down box.
Wow.
And as you can see, these are all the sources from which Addict-O-Matic will pull the information for your page.
That's
a tremendous amount. It's a very powerful search tool. So let's say I know that in the district that we don't do YouTube. So I'm going to deselect that by just clicking off of that. What else do you think we need to deselect?
Well, let's see. We could probably turn off the Google blog search because a lot of blogs are blocked. They've got blog lines on the right there. And WordPress over here on the right. And then WordPress 2 down from it because that's also a blog thing.
Uh-huh.
Well, let's leave up Twingly. I've never seen Twingly.
Okay. Is that it?
Yeah, let's try that.
Well, let's scroll down and see what we have. So look at all this. Topics. Live.com news.
You mean it did it while we were unchecking those?
That's
it updated
correct.
It?
When we unchecked it took the widget from the screen. So YouTube is not even going to be on here because we've already deselected. There's Twitter.
Okay. Lee Colbert loves Twitter.
Yes.
He's really very into that.
And as you can see, all this information is specifically about our search.
Okay. So if we went to that Yahoo, the first article in Yahoo on the Google cell phone, and clicked on that, that would try to launch it, and we'd naturally hit the district thing again. Always something there.
Yes.
A lot of these are on blogs, so that could be a problem.
Yes.
If you're working in a company that might have things filtered for you.
That's restricted, yes.
So if we go to, like, CNN, you said CNN is on here, too?
Yes, sometimes they have CNN videos.
Wow. So there's an awful lot of things on it, and there's a true video thing.
So let's see.
We're going to see if one of these works.
Yeah, let's see if one of the videos works.
So that seems to be launching. That's from the newsroom. So this goes out, and it brings in a lot of information for you from multiple resources all at once. That is awesome.
And then there's your video. You could just play your video from here.
So you could find out about the new T-Mobile G1, which is the Google cell phone that's supposed to have some really cool features.
That's right, and it'll give you in video format.
Nice. So what would be some great uses for this one?
Well, I like it because you can save your page. You can customize your own page, and you can save it. So if you wanted to do a search for, let's say even in a social studies classroom, if you were doing current events and you wanted to look about the presidential debates, you could look up debate and it will pull up all of the source information for debates. And you can send your students there and they can look at the videos, they can look at clips of the debates, they can get primary sources, they can write based on this launching tube. So you can use it for personal reasons as well. For example, if you were very interested in events of the day, you can say, you know what, I want the most recent information about the Google cell phone. And every day when you come in, it will have this information posted for you, and you're able to pull up that information.
So this really hits all three of our audiences. Students could use this as research for term papers or presentations. Teachers could use this to get the latest information on something they want to show in their class. And our general public audience could use this for anything that's business related, This is a great resource.
It really is, and I like it because it is up-to-date information. A lot of times when we're doing research on history, sometimes it, just in geography, whatever it is, a lot of times it's older information, even if it's 2 months old or 3 months old. But this is today. This happened yesterday. This happened this morning. And there are videos, there are articles, there are blogs, there are different types of sources. So when you're looking for it, you can actually get a diverse opinion on the different news of the day. And I think that's very important.
Now, I usually have a reputation for killing these things, and I like to try bizarre things. You're a math teacher. Let's type in mathematics and see what we would get.
Ooh, now that was an interesting search because it usually is for current events.
And we might find events that are related to mathematics. So this is interesting. And look at
look at this. There's a math team that placed in a competition. Wow.
So almost anything could be searched on here. And you get great results.
How neat is that? That's exactly right.
So if we did a search on something like the economy.
I'm sure there would be so much.
Yeah, a lot of our viewers might be interested in that. And sure enough, we get that login thing. So what you're looking for. Anything is out there, and it's going to research it in several different areas.
So instead of you getting your Wall Street Journal and your New York Times and getting all of your magazines, you just put it in here, and it pulls all that information up for you in one fell swoop.
And what's the bookmark and share section over there? So we would go to this, and we would be able to use some of the social bookmarking programs out there.
That's right. Facebook or whatever it is, and you can share that.
Share it with the rest of the world.
That's right.
That is really, really nice. What a great program, Jamey.
Really good features. Really good features.
So what else can you show us about this?
Well, if you ever have any questions, I like this tab here.
FAQ. That's almost the same as help. That's a really good one to have.
And so this is where I like to start when I'm beginning a project like this because it will allow me to go through each of the questions that I would normally have. So it has facts and answers of questions. So
that
explains a lot of things for you.
And it was good for us to have an opportunity to explain things that happen in different filter systems. If you're at work, if you're in a school district, different areas are going to have different filtering levels. In fact, at home, parents may have filtering systems installed on the home computer.
That's exactly right.
That's great. Well, thanks, Jamey. And right now we're going to go back over to Kim. We're going to bring Kim on the set, and we'll be back in a minute with more on Palm Breeze Cafe.